So if you want to measure temperature using a thermistor and an Arduino, over the next 4 minutes I'll show you how. The Arduino platform lets you do all kinds of neat things, like plot temperatures on a graph, or save to an SD card for later data analysis. What you're going to need is a Arduino Uno Mega, doesn't really matter, a thermistor, a resistor, some hookup wire, and to make things nice and easy, a solderless breadboard. And if you want to snazzy up your project, add an LCD or an SD card for logging some data. The most important thing you're going to need is a data sheet. I'm using an NTC, a negative temperature coefficient, meaning when temperature goes up, the resistance goes down. And just by the color coding on the thermistor, I know exactly what type of unit I have. Also, when I bought my thermistor, I got this data sheet with it. The most important thing you're going to need to get out of the data sheet are the equations to figure out what the temperature is based on the resistance. My data sheet gave me two equations. One is where I can calculate the resistance based on the known temperature. The other one is where I can plug in the resistance and figure out what the actual temperature is. However, I'm going to need some coefficients to figure out exactly what the right values are. That's where the data table comes in. With my known thermistor, I know the values for A1, B1, C1, and D1, and plug them into the equation. The trick with this process is measuring the actual resistance from the thermistor. Measuring the resistance can be done with a voltage divider. It's simply a couple of resistors hooked in series, so if I put a voltage across both of those resistors, I could measure the voltage drop across each of the resistors, R1 or R2. So I'm going to use my Arduino to put some 5 volts on VI, and then I'm going to measure the VO, a voltage across the resistor R2, which will be my thermistor. The equation is simple. Voltage out equals voltage in times R2 divided by the sum of those resistance values. Now I'll just do some algebra to solve for R2. See, if you ever thought, I'm in algebra class, and I hate it, I don't get it, I'm never going to use this ever again. Well, chances are you probably are, and if you like to do electronics projects, you're going to have to fall in love with algebra. Now that it's solved, we know the value of R2, and I'll plug this into my Arduino so I can calculate the value of R2. Before we go any further, let's make sure our Arduino is putting out 5 volts and what the value of our resistor is. Then we're ready to hook up our project. To create a voltage divider, just take your resistor and thermistor and hook them in series. Then connect positive 5 volts to the resistor and ground to the thermistor. And right between the two where they're connected, that's where I'm going to measure my my drop, which is the pin A0. Now let's take a look at the code. We'll have some doubles for A1, B1, C1 that you saw earlier in the data sheet, and some doubles for our temperature calculations. And here are my constants that came from the actual data sheet. I'll set a pin mode to input for my pin A0, and I'll measure that voltage. Then I'll simply convert that to the actual voltage itself with a simple conversion. And then the actual equation that we derived earlier. Now I can calculate what R2 is. Now that I have R2, I simply plug it in that giant equation that we got from the data sheet, which will give us temperature in degrees Kelvin. And then I can convert that to Celsius and Fahrenheit. So I'm going to run my program. I'll write everything to the serial window. And you can see the temperature based on the thermistor. Now to snazzy it up, let me add a little LCD screen, and as I squeeze the thermistor, notice how the temperature goes up. And if you really want to get creative, we can put this on a much better display and see the actual graph of the temperature over time. Watch my other videos to get a free download to this graphing function. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching.